shit.
Hello guys, this is Ayos Graphics and welcome to my channel. If you're new to my channel, please click on the subscribe button and click on the notification bell to get notified anytime I release a video. So today I'm going to show you how to shade from A to Z, how to shade using the airbrush and the hard airbrush, the soft airbrush and the hard airbrush. So all we're going to do is create a new layer, select a felt pen and then select your color, your base color, then fill up your sketch. Make sure the layer of your base color is under the sketch, the layer of your paint is under your sketch. Then try and fill up your sketch neatly. So guys, we're going to be adding a new layer and we're going to select the dark color for the combo that we're going to use, the color we're going to use for the shading. So that's the third color. So we're going to select the airbrush. We'll set it to full 100% opacity. Then we'll set the size. We can set the size, just depends on what project you are working on. I don't have a specific number of size that I do work on, so it depends on where you are shading exactly. So first of all, we're going to start shading the top of the eye. That's the dark shade of the eye, where the shadow comes out much. So we're starting from the top of the eye. As you can see, I'm reducing the size of my airbrush to 4.2 and I'm following exactly what is on the reference. So make sure your reference is in between the base color, a field pen, and the shading layer. Make sure it's in between the layer for the paint and also for the shading. So just try and emulate exactly what you're seeing on the reference. Just copy exactly what you're seeing on the reference. Make sure you can reduce the opacity of your soft airbrush if you are not used to shading, so as to easily erase your mistake. Make sure it's not thick like mine. You can also use your soft cleaner, just in case you've done a mistake on the shading. You can use your soft cleaner to erase any mistake you've made. So as you can see, I'm trying to shade according to the reference. Just keep on shading. You can readjust the size of your airbrush and just keep on shading. Make sure it's going according to the reference. Make sure it's going according to the reference, and that's it. In case you want to use the same reference I used on this video, a link will be dropped in the description box, so you can just go there and click on it to download. So as you can see, under the reference, we can see some shadows under the reference. So we're going to just copy exactly what is there to our own shading layer. We're going to just shade according to what we've seen on the reference. So as you can see, these shadows, you're just going to copy exactly what is there. Just use your hard airbrush and just copy the shadows. Just follow according to how it mustn't be exactly, it mustn't be as perfect as the reference, but make sure you copy something aligned with it. Make sure it's not contrary. Just make sure you just do exactly what you see on the reference. Make sure the shadow pops out. And as you can see, so far so good. The work is getting interesting and it's turning out to be a very nice painting. So what you're going to do is that you go to your color combo, select another fourth color, make sure it's darker than the previous one, then make sure you create a new layer for the darker shadow, that is the second dark shadow. Then you just follow the reference, make sure you reshade the most darkest place in the reference. Just look for the most darkest place in the reference and use the combo on it. Make sure you are following according to the reference. Don't go contrary. Just make sure you select the darker color. Just follow according to the reference. Just look for the darkest sheets. Just look for the darker sheets, then use the color on it and you're good to go. Make sure you're using your hot airbrush, for the dark, the second dark shading, so as to make it to look more intense and thicker than the previous one. So make sure the opacity of your hard airbrush is 100 or less. You can make it 50. Depends on your project. Depends on what you're working on. You can make it 50. You can make it 80. But make sure you're using the hard airbrush. Okay, friends, study the lightning. Then you gradually apply it.